Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to insert an image into a shape in Adobe Photoshop. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first I'm going to get my image into Photoshop, and this one I downloaded from pexels.com. I'll click and drag it onto my Adobe Photoshop icon. And now it's open. Now we need a shape. So let's draw one. I'll make a star, and to do that, I'll get on the Polygon tool, which is right down here. And yours might look like a rectangle tool because this one is actually underneath the rectangle tool. And I'm going to hold shift and click and drag. Then I'll come over here in my properties panel, and I'm just going to change this to 50 to see what that looks like, and then hit tab. And that comes up with a perfect star. Now, if I want a different kind of star, I can change this to 75 and hit tab. And that makes that kind of star, but you can play around with that and come up with the shape you want. I'm gonna go ahead with this 50% star. Next, I'll come up here and get on my move tool. You can also hit V on your keyboard. And I'm gonna just position this about where I want. It doesn't have to be perfect. Next, I'll unlock my background. And then I'm going to pull that background layer above the star layer. So we won't be able to see the star. It's back there, but it's covered up. Now I'll right click on my top layer and choose Create Clipping Mask. Now that's how to insert a photo into a shape. You can also reposition the photo back there because it's not actually cut out. So if we click on this top layer, we can click and move that photo around. Or we can click on the bottom layer and move just the star around. To move both around at the same time, I'm going to select the top layer, hold shift and select the bottom layer, and then group those. And I'll toggle this down so you can see what's inside. I'll click on the group here in my layers panel. I'll make sure I'm on my move tool, and now I can move them both around. Now we have a transparent background here, so I'm going to add a new layer. I'll pull it to the bottom. I'm going to click on my foreground color and make it, just kind of a tannish yellow, and we'll say okay. So I've changed my foreground color. Now I need to fill my layer with that. To do that, I'll hit Option Delete. That will fill with whatever is in the foreground. Now what about a non-uniform shape that doesn't come preloaded in Photoshop? You can actually copy and paste vectors from Illustrator. So let's try this. I've got vector artwork here in Illustrator. I'm just gonna copy this, and then I'll come back to Photoshop and I'll paste. I like to do smart object because you can resize it without losing any quality. So I'll say okay. Super small, I'll get on a corner and hold shift and make that quite a lot larger. And then I'm gonna just hold option and click and drag this layer to the top. So holding option or alt will make a copy if you click and drag a layer. And then I'll bring the vector that I just brought in as a smart object and move it to the top. And we'll just go ahead and hide this other group that we made, the star. I'll click on my image layer and kind of move that where I want, behind the raindrops. And then once it's ready, I'll click and drag it to the top. Now I can do the same thing I did before. Right click and choose Clipping Mask, or you can also hit Option Command G or Alt Control G on a PC. And then I'll bring back the star. And then of course, if you want the image behind here to be in a different spot, you can move that around. Or you can move the raindrops around in the same way. You just need to be clicked on the correct layer. Now there's one more scenario that I want to go over with you, and that's if you have like a black and white JPEG. I'm going to go ahead and place a file in like that. I'm going to make a new layer, and then I'll go to File, Place Embedded, and I've got a cat JPEG. It's just black and white. I'll place that. And I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. We'll put it over here. And then I'll hit enter or return to commit those changes. I'll right click on the layer and come down to rasterize layer. Then I'll hit W on my keyboard, and that'll bring me to the magic wand tool, which is right over here. Once I have that tool, I can select subject. And then I'll hit Command J or Control J to put that cat on the new layer. Come down to the original and just delete that. And then say yes. So now I have the cat shape. I'm going to hold Option or Alt to copy this layer again, and I'll put it above the cat. I'm just going to position it over the cat. Actually, I probably want the cat on top at first, just so I can see what part of the image I want him to be filled with. Maybe this part right here. Then I'll put the image back on top, hit Option Command G or Alt Control G to get a clipping mask, and then it works the same way as the other clipping masks. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.